Well, hi everybody.
Excuse the lack of dog, but what is this? Whoa! Actually, beware of dog. Hi, Cerberus. Welcome to tonight's stream. I'm Danny, and this is the unofficial mascot of the Dallas Stars, Cer. Hockey boy. Speaking of hockey, what is this? Minus the NHL thing have in common, and what is possibly the polar opposite of these? Although, knowing Michael, he's probably going to want to see me do these on stream eventually, because it's fucking Gex. It's got nothing to do with the stream, I swear to God. Tonight we're doing a game called Tape to Tape. Those of you that know the original schedule, we were originally supposed to do Minecraft Legends. I can explain. You see, what happened was, Arthur, what are you doing here?
Hey, don't get camera shot now, you little shit. Get back here. Arthur Ulysses Henry.
Yeah, that's right, I'm using your middle name.
He'll come to lick himself. But when he wants to get on camera, he's like, no. I'm the Cat-thum of the opera, as it were. Either way, what happened was this. I was gonna do Minecraft Legends, and then Cat sees an ad for Tape to Tape on Twitch, which is the first time I can remember an indie sports game that I've ever been interested in ever have, like, space on the Twitch fucking front page of some kind, and she gifts it to me. Anybody that knows me knows I'm going to pick hockey over fucking Minecraft every day of the week. Don't worry though, it will happen. I don't know when, but it will happen. Also, guess who has to worry about weather again? Oh, I see Michael said duh. I'm doing this gag again. I believe these games are tickling his fancy. The fancy's being tickled. The fancy's going, it's so tickled. Either way, eventually we'll get to those. But yes, a game that's like this, we have done the demo a couple of months ago. And if you check the YouTube, we even did an early first look review at the demo. Now, the game that we're doing tonight is in early access. It's not completely ready yet. It's not out of early access yet. It's like just launched, ready to go. So, there's probably gonna be some fuck shit with it, and I accept that. But with that being said, folks, are we ready to hit the ice? Are we ready to play hockey in May? Are we ready for some intense playoff action? You see, Michael, he a Ducks fan. Y'all gotta forgive me. Playoff hockey is what happens when you are one of the top 8 teams in your conference. And you get to play... You get to play longer because you good. Oh God, I love doing that. Speaking of doing good, my boys, take care of Seattle, please. Nothing against the fan base. Y'all some beautiful sons of bitches, but y'all. Cup supremacy. It's been since... I also have a Devils jersey, and they my homies too, but Carolina is whooping they ass. As of the time of this review, if you're watching this on YouTube, this is context sensitive. New Jersey just got the ass beat by Carolina in the playoffs, 6-1. I've seen beatings. That's the type of beating that you'd think Wrong Dimension would be my dom if I took a beating like that. Anyway... Are you guys ready? I'm ready. You're ready? But what? I buried the lead. Tape to Tape, however, this is the thing we gotta get through. Roguelike. It's got a story mode and shit like that. So this could be something I could bring back repeatedly. Also, Garu, I hope you're here, motherfucker. I am doing a roguelike of my own volition and willingly. It's always the times I do shit he never thinks I'll do, and then he's gonna be like, poof. He ain't gonna be here. Watch. Bet. So, are we ready? Without further ado, without any other interruptions, whatever, without any other double entendres to a certain boyfriend that is also a mod, which I'll see you later. we got hockey. It's hockey night in Texas. Here comes the game, folks. This is gonna be a good one. Why is it small? I need it large. Dummy thick. What is this? Enlarge. See on the intro promo thing, it was big. Why is it over here? It's on this monitor? For what? I thought I had it on this monitor. Motherfucker. Tales of an ancient club that could restore hockey to its former glory. They talking about the Maple Leafs, because them motherfuckers ain't win shit in a while. Angus McShaggy, former golf legend, has been on a tireless quest to find the sacred relic when a message from his brother sends him on a journey to the fabled land, hockey's last stronghold. I know they ain't talking about Winnipeg. Ain't no way. To restore his beloved sport, Angus must now unravel the island mysteries and prove his worth. That's right, boy, make that contract. Not the AHL, NHL. Yes, my boy. Aw, what is this? Who let Michael be the goalie? Now, who put the disaster fluffle in between the pipes? Come on now. Got him tied up and everything. Oh, you're right. You're right. It could act theoretically that'd be more like Garu, because he'd be like, I don't want to play hockey. But then again, if we tried to fucking make Garu tied up like that in a hockey thing, we know damn well what would happen. He'd damn near melt the ice. Okay, I gotta get the settings, because I don't like the fact that I can't stare right into your souls. You, the consumer. Let me scroll this over. Oh, now it's too damn large. Could be my future girlfriend. Oh, howdy, Alistair. I didn't know you did hockey. Wait a minute. It's a sports game, and for some reason, Alistair plays me close in sports games. This game doesn't exist. It got canceled. It's doused in holy water. Cat was a Angel was a developer on it. You don't want this. There you go, homeboy. I mean, I got several questions to ask. Don't move. Yes. Oh, sweet Jesus! I have a headhunter skill? Head smasher. Oh, no fucking better. Damn. Sweet Jesus. I ain't mean to do all that. Wait, is my head short enough to do hats? Let me see. Yes, kind of is. It's more like, it'd be more like this, but it ain't gonna work. See, this shit don't look right on me. Did you do me the honor check and body check the poor lad? Yeet. I'm barely here like the last few streams, but I felt like I needed to react to that. I have ideas on how to use a goal for rope fun. Oh, lordy lord. Woo! Woo! Yeah, that's right. Considering how half the playoff has been fucking called, ooh, you might want to do that to some of your teams, huh? You can leave now and start your quest. Yeah, that's right. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of the Sins. Speaking of the Sins, apparently Snoop Dogg is trying to buy the Ottawa Senators. I'ma leave that to y'all. Welcome to Tape to Tape's development journey. We appreciate you joining us as we fine-tune the game during the early access. Our team is committed to adding new content on a regular basis, incorporating your feedback on the gameplay. We're currently working on tuning the game's campaign's difficulty to create a fair and challenging rough experience for players of all levels. Those pesky referees might actually need to be nerfed. Bet. Good. Yes. Have fun and go win that cup. You goddamn Skippy. What the hell? Why did Twitter come up? That's weird. Sorry about that. It is campaign time. But no, I do appreciate all of y'all that remember that, hey, there's stream Saturday. Ooh, boy. Angus already, I've told you about my uncle who popularized batting the punk in the air with the shot button. What's going on in the shop? What y'all got around here, baby? Why is he menacing? You gotta get mean and be nasty about it. Oh shit, they got a little different difficulties. Casual. Ideal for players learning about the game before a first playthrough. Standard. The ideal experience for most players and expert. For players who... Okay, so let's do standard, because we already... And if we suck, we can go back down, but judging my hockey background, I don't think I should suck that bad. Not the other type of suck. He enjoys that type of suck, but don't worry about that. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the main thing. Ooh, a dash button, the head smasher, or spinorama. As much as I like me a good old-fashioned, big, dummy, thick spinorama, I think I'm going to go with the head smasher for my first run. I think that's going to be a little bit better. Okay, he's accurate. I like Rory McShaggy because he ain't bad at anything. He's not good at anything, but he's solid. Everybody else got like something they fucking suck at. So I'ma pick this solid homeboy right here. Okay, so we got a good, decent, team. Not necessarily great, but not miserable either, which is always a good thing. By the way, my realm does have something like hockey, just more like how soccer was originally, just on ice. Oh, I actually did a TikTok earlier. Now, just for some reason, Alistair reminds me of my goddamn sister, so there you go. Fucking... I got asked about cute games that go to hell, and I tried to think of something that wasn't like Cult of the Lamb, where it's obvious it's gonna be cute and fucked up. But I also, at the same time, wasn't trying to think of stuff like, ice soccer. Ice soccer sounds fucking dope. I wasn't also trying to think of a horror game, because that's too fucking easy. I fucked around and remembered I had a game called Raises Hell. So, eventually, if I ever become good at that game, I need to go show y'all, hey, look, I get to blow up Teletubbies. I know y'all. Turnip boy commits tax evasion. Yeah, that shit got dark quick. More brutal. I don't think Lollipop Chainsaw would qualify as cute. Not really, because, I mean, the chainsaw, the zombies, like you knew what was going on. I know she does the cute poses, but, like, there's a difference. Like, it starts off, like, she said that if it started off cute, then turned fucked up. So, like, it started, like, it starts off fucked up from the giddy up. Like, level one is the zombie apocalypse. You know what I'm saying? Like, at least with Raises Hell, you have that slow descent into why do I have to kill all the cute bastards? You know what I'm saying? Sir, what's going on, buddy? Cerberus has joined. It's hockey. The mascot has to show up for it. Ain't it right? Ooh, get hit. All right, let's get this over with. Just go over here. Oh, he caught that. Okay, was not expecting that. Come on, spread out. Oh. Oh, damn, that didn't get in? We are rifling off shots on him and nothing. Jesus. Oh, come on, 61. Ah, sweet Jesus. El defense grande. I need like petite defense a little bit. Come on. Oh, that almost hit it. Is that going to go in? No. We have two of their dudes laid the fuck out. I don't know how much more we can do to them. Off the fucking board. Jesus. It's in. We got it. Hey. Yeah, I have to keep the door open because Serby's going to go back and forth. Ref, thank you for the assist, my boy. You're the real MVP. So we just had to score one goal and did exactly that. Good shit. Swing by my shop after your work. All right,
sir, if you're not coming back, buddy, come on, get on in.
There you go. Oh shit. So that's the thing from the demo we didn't know about. Okay, that's nice. Serb's making it be an indoor-outdoor stream because he's just like, I want to be here. I want to be there. I want to be here. I want to be everywhere. Temporarily gained 50 points overall. God damn, that would be broken.
All right, Serb. Come on.
I'm over here like, pick one. Yeah, he's well-rounded, so that might work for him. Alright, so should we go to train? Or should we go for the mysterious event? Oh, I'm feeling froggy. Mysterious event. Wait a minute. An old sage offers to teach your goalie a new technique at a cost. The goaltender can master the art of farting or how to headshot with his blocker. The implications of which choice is unclear. What the fuck? We gotta pick one. Gain goalie fart skill, but can't catch from the glove anymore. I don't like that idea. Gain goalie headshot, but your blocker is smaller. Who the fuck? Give me the headshot. I could deal with a smaller fucking blocker. Because, I mean, not like they're gonna be on that side of the ice too damn long anyway. What the fuck, though? Look at these bootleg Maple Leaf looking motherfuckers. Okay, so it's just two periods. Got it. Oh, almost, almost. Oh, he was down. Shit, 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 shit. He got lit up. Just let that. You gotta be better than that. Yeah, freeze the puck. I couldn't even do what I wanted to do on that. Come on, 61. Get open. Get open. You got open, but you wound up going too damn. Lord have mercy. Oh, the damn ref! Oh, you punk bitch! For your transgressions, my boy! Just threw it right to the motherfucker, too, huh? God damn. I'm not shocked. I'm not stunned. I'm not surprised. Soon as I saw him give up the puck, I'm like, ah, shit. Brace for impact. Here we go. Yep. As expected. God damn it. Okay, we got to start using these damn abilities. That's what we got to do. Oh. Ooh, there you go. That's how you answer that, my man. Left him all alone on that one. Jesus. Just said, no, you know what? I'm just going to sneak right past you and just slap one good top left. Ain't nobody catching up to that. That's a good goal. Oh, I hit the damn bar. Nope. Yeah, that's right. This is property of me. Oh, it is the ref trying to take my ass out. Okay, no, 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 no. I got you, buddy. I got you, pal. Got you, friendo. Did we get him? Oh. Tied at one after one. Okay, so... real simple. We gotta make sure we don't do that shit again. Okay. Get your ass out of my way. I'm out here hunting skulls, buddy. Oh, get open, get open, get open. Damn. Almost. Ref, you got one more elbow, and I'm going to take your goddamn kneecaps and bitch slap you with them and use them as a goddamn jockstrap. It is brawling time. Oh, got him. Wait, say, hey, why did you slow up, my man? Whatever Vegas is paying you, I'll double it. Oh, that hurt. That hit him. All out goal. There you go. That's the type of shit I need. My boy, celebrate. Party time. Just nothing but a sweet, good old-fashioned, pure, unrefined breakaway. Also didn't help that somebody apparently knocked him down, which meant that he went up 50 overall, which, whoo boy, apparently that goalie is great, but he ain't good enough. So we're up 2-1. All we gotta do is not fuck up, folks. Ooh, the glass chipped on that shot. Got it. And it's in! Two goals in 10 seconds or so. There you go, buddy. That is the icing on that cake. Go on home, boys, boys, girls, ladies and gentlemen. The greasy lettuce has been washed. Yeah, that'll do it. Two goals in about 30 seconds, so long as we play solid D. We're going to move on. There we go. Ooh, almost. As long as we can waste the rest of the time, I think we'll be all right. Yeah, no, that'll do it. Just got to get a good outlet pass. Or at least play keep away. Fuck it, we'll play keep away. And one for the road. God damn. I'll take that every day of the week. I was just trying to kill time. They were like, no, concede defeat. Go ahead, take the goal. And I'm like, I'm much obliged. I like gifts on the way out. Nice little parting gift for myself. It's like going to a barbecue and taking a plate for yourself, and it's nothing but cheeseburgers. And that's the final score, 4-1. We're not dead yet. Damn, there's 10 viewers for hockey. Hey, how y'all doing? How you doing? Go, Danny, go. Why, thank you. Puck Dynasty, I got an achievement? Oh, there you go. Fuck yeah. Gain a temporary random skill at the start of each game. Okay, cool. This motherfucker is weak as shit on checking, so maybe that'll fix his checking. Remind me to never challenge you to a hockey game. I'm not that bad. But yeah, no, a hockey roguelike, this is pretty much how it goes. And hey, look, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not even mad. I'm just over here like the one time I'm like, yes, I will do a roguelike, and Garu ain't here. Because it was like fucking what happened last Saturday night. Fucking dude Knuckles Chaotix. I'm doing a platformer. Next, I'm going to fuck around and do a JRPG and he ain't going to be here. Oh, that shit pretty my. That's just funny. Oh, God. Okay. But no, I'm not that bad. You got a shot. You have a shot. You may not win, but you got a chance. You see, in a perfect world, everybody's got a 50-50% chance of winning. But I'm genetically good at hockey. So I have a 75% chance of winning. Yes, this is Steiner math all over again. So if you were to put me versus Michael in a game of hockey, you take my 50% chance. You put it on top of my 75% chance, and you take his 25% chance, and you take 12.5% chance off it, because he's not even going to try. And you take another 6% off of that, because he's going to use the ducks, and we all know the ducks ain't shit. That means... That means he only got a 6% chance of winning. So you take my 75% chance plus my 50% chance. And that's already a 125% chance of winning. But you know what he's going to do is use the ducks. So that means he only got a 6% chance of winning. So you take my 125% chance of winning plus 94% chance. You got a 200, I got a 219% chance of winning. You see, Michael, the numbers don't lie and they spell disaster. See what happens. Angus stumbles upon a pack of rabid dogs. He befriends them and learns their secrets of intimidation. From now on, opponents close to Angus with the puck will flee him and miss the net. Oh, I like that. Who do we got on the lineup, though? Oh, sweet Jesus. Ooh, that was funny. For the record, yes, I know the mat was miserable, and it was on purpose, okay? So, those of you that are worried, those of you that ain't great at mat, don't copy that. That shit ain't gonna track, okay? That's... Wrestling fans, though, you knew exactly what that clip was about, and I appreciate y'all. Oh shit, I need water after that. God damn. Woo. How do y'all put up with me? It has to be a McShaggy. How the fuck can he smell the AstroTurf on me? Wait a minute, that's concerning. I like how Michael's just like, God damn you, Danny. Why do you do this to me? I do it out of love. I don't know. Oh, shit. Okay, let's see what we got here. Just a regular two-period game of hockey. All right, cool. Oh, that was a nice poke. That was a nice poke. Damn! Right before I could set up the pass, I got laid the fuck out. Give me that. Oh, there's no icing. There's no wrap. The ref ain't here but to be an obstacle, apparently. Because we ain't got nothing. Oh, this has been a sloppy first period so far. God damn. The ref did the Lord's work, apparently. That's my boy. That was the world's most dangerous pass. Oh, there we go. There you go. Off the rebound and in. We draw first blood.
Sloppier than
Michael. Nerdy Beauregard disaster fluffle. Raw Dimension is gonna kill me. Probably. Would we be shocked at that? At least we're cutting off their good chances, which works. Oh, and the ref is down. Okay, now it's become bully ball all over again. Welcome to Philadelphia, apparently. Jesus. What are you unaliving people for now? Look at Michael's comment. Just... And we got out of the first period. What a wild fucking first. 1-0. Not bad. Why am I not shocked at that turn of events? Come on, get in there. There you go. Damn, this goalie lets a lot of friggin' rebounds off. I'll take it every day of the week, however. Just bounce, bounce, and right in, just exactly where he wasn't gonna be. Oh, that was almost good, but I thought, like, no one's ever heard of a femboy killing so. That is out of pocket, Michael! Jesus!
No one's ever heard of a femboy doing killing.
The femboy's got a 9. You better run. All right, 55 more seconds if we can get out of here and survive yet another game. Okay, we got right where I thought it would happen. Exactly where I thought it would happen. See, this team's dangerous. You got to stay the fuck off the boards with them. You don't necessarily want to constantly clear the damn puck either. Oh, there you go. I thought we could have had it. Ooh, that was just nothing but fire and brimstone on that slap shot. 3-0. Again, we just love them pardon gifts. Yeah, that's right. I'm about to leave the barbecue. Can you just give me some potato salad, mac and cheese on that a dish? But yeah, if they weren't dead and buried, somebody just took a nail gun to the coffin on that shot. That's 2 shutout. That's a shutout, baby. And again, we moving on. Hey, look. What can I say? It's a hockey game and it's me. Did y'all expect anything less? Whew. You're doing good. Okay, gotta check something real quick. We are also getting a fuck ton of rubber, so whenever we actually finish up, we'll have some intriguing, interesting stuff going. Whew. Yes, also, Angel, I just saw your message. Yeah, you did bet right. God damn, this game is good. Cause some strife and you get the knife. Every player grows and gets plus 10 checking. Rare berry. Gain 20 overall for 15 seconds after winning a face-off. We do get our share of face-offs. Okay, it's either giganticism or rare berry. I'm thinking giganticism, because knocking motherfuckers down is the goal. Can't score on me if your ass is on the ice. Getting laid out. Oh, howdy, Garudy Rutherford Fairfeather. I'm willingly doing a roguelike. Alright, we're gonna get one more rest. And then we gotta fight the boss. Train to rest. 4 overall is helpful. To all players? To everybody? Forever? Forever ever? Forever ever? Yeah, take that. Besides, they've been on a roll. You gotta reward your team when they got a hot streak. You gotta let them cool down a little bit. Who we got? The goddamn referees. I knew they were throwing bowls for a reason. It was practice. And with reward, we get an artifact. All right. I've been wanting to do this to referees like Buffalo fans wanted to beat their ass after the 99 Cup. Now, as a Dallas Stars fan, it was a good goal. I ain't saying shit about it, but I'm just citing the historical reference. That's all. Oh yeah, I'm about to whoop my ass some referees. Woo! Pop over the weasel because the weasel said pop. Is that a fucking baseball umpire? That's a motherfucking baseball umpire. What the hell is he doing here? Y'all hoes on strike again for the very 15th time this week? Lying asses. You lying motherfuckers. Oh, no. I played the demo. You can't fool me. I know what to expect. And you need to expect that I'm gonna knock that mustache straight. You understand me? Your ass about to get beat. Paragons of virtue. I'm about to call me Red Foreman because I'm about to be the paragon of putting my foot up your ass. Understand me? Get a load of these lying bitches, though. May the fairest win. Boy, I'm about to kick you in the dick with the blade. Come on now. Bring it. Danny Foreman. The whole damn team big as hell for no reason. All of you refs about to get your ass beaten. If I see an NFL referee on this goddamn ice, as a New Orleans Saints fan, it is my job to whoop your ass. The 2019 NFC Championship game against the Rams. It's time, buddy. It's time, Chief. You gonna get what you deserve, my boy. What y'all doing? What you doing? Who the fuck are you shooting at? You ain't even shooting that shit. Come on. Come on, Cletus. Lucky I don't start a line brawl on this motherfucker. Are y'all calling rules? They actually called icing in this motherfucker? Hold up. What y'all gonna call next? Roughing? Interference? Icing? Well, they actually done already called icing. Oh, your ref ain't. Don't do it. You ain't gonna do it. You ain't got it. I told you ain't have it with your slippery ass. Chaos in front of the goddamn net and nothing came of it. Son of a bitch. Oh, there the pass. Come on, baby. Oh, off the blocker. God damn. I thought I had that bitch. It went right off his gate. Where you think you're going? Where you think you're going, buddy? Mm-hmm. That's why your ass got shoved. Come on. Come on round. Oh, he caught it. He'll put a skate in your ass the American way. Fuck. Be red, white, and bluesed in this. I'm out here laughing. Red, white, and bruised in this motherfucker. Understand me? Ass will be beaten. Oh, boy. Is that in? Oh, he got it with his glove. I don't know what the lyrics were. They sounded fucking not miserable. See, that's the thing about country. They just slip up on you. They just pop up on you for no fucking reason. Oh, that's going out. Oh, no, we got possession of it. Is that in? No. Swung on and missed. Did that just hit the ref in the ass? Well, time to make him pay. It is a wild brawl. Nobody really got any separation so far. It's just been nothing but hits and hits and hits and hits and a slap shot and a hit during the slap shot. Fuck it. Nothing. Ah, damn. Yeah, they got a good one on that. Yeah, that's a good goal. Stevie Wonder can see that. All I did was sub skate for boots. More hits than a record label. We're down 1-0 though, so I can't really celebrate too hard. That time I can blame the refs and I can't blame the refs. Cause like I could be like, goddamn you refs, you scored. But it's not like in the demo when they fucking, you know, took that bullshit goal. So I can't even be mad. My goalie just stank. I can only imagine what happens when and if you collect all the changes in this. That's another thing, yeah. Oh, we got it. We got him. Oh, off the goalie again. Oh, there we go. There's the shuffle. There's the nothing. Oh, you hoes try to get bold. You all bounced off just wide. That'd have been a good one. Damn. Okay, there we go. There we go. There we go. Get open. Tap it in and it's in. Goal. That's a good one, baby. That's how you do that there. That's how you do that there, my boy. That is how it goes. And we're tied again. Just stole it from him like a bully in elementary school and right to the top of the net. That is beautiful. Nope. Who the hell is he shooting that one at? Did he want to give his wife in the front row a souvenir? Because that worked if he was doing that. I don't know how effective, but it was something. All right, come on, come on. Stretch the pond on him. Get in and get done. That is another goal, and that's a lead, boys. Hey, you blind? Hey, you blind? You blind? Don't make me. I will go and play this game on an Indian burial ground and play this on a big-ass TV, and then I will jump into that motherfucker poltergeist style just to whoop your ass because you know that was a good goal. Your mother should have swallowed. All I'm going to say is that November, somebody should say that maybe we need to legalize you not being around no more, homie. I'm not even saying it. I'm just saying, nah, fuck you, buddy. All right, you want to play. You want to play. You lucky, because I'd whoop your ass. Your mom's a hoe. You understand me? Your mama went to a Ducks game and got a fucking puck to the side of the head from Wild Wing, didn't she? Your daddy ain't shit either. I heard your daddy was Gordon Bombay with half the talent. Those of y'all that seen the Ducks movies, you know. Weather is clear so far. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They were saying that be prepared for like pretty much apocalypse ass weather. Now say that wasn't a good goal. Come on. Stevie Wonder can see it was good. Do it one good time. Say it, bitch. I dare you. I double dog dare you, motherfucker. Say it wasn't a good goal. Say it. Come on. Thought so. I was about ready to whoop that referee's ass. I live in a world where Tupac... Look, if people can get away with Tupac, people can get away with Biggie, I can get away with you, motherfucker. Don't think... So you better call this game right from here on in. Oh, just clear it. There we go. Now, what you gonna do about that, officer? Mr. Official?
Nothing.
You know, the reason why Garu is silent right now, it's not because he's tired. You wanna know why the truth reason is? He's gonna be like, I wonder how many other roguelikes I can get Danny to play right this instant. Yeah, I deserve that. But don't worry. I will get my damn vengeance. But that was just poor-ass defense. Fucking got left wide open on a one-timer I bit and just... Yeah, that deflection, deadly. Deadly. Once you have to go all the way to the other side, leaving a gap that wide, it's happening. So we're back tied at 2. Oh! He had trouble with the puck! That is a textbook case of why whenever you play hockey, do not never have it to where you are 2-on-1 or anything like that. You gonna fuck around and just put your goalie in no man's land. And unless your name is Jake Ottinger, it ain't gonna go well for you. That's for damn sure. We Texans love us some otter. You hockey fans will understand that reference, okay? Just... Gotta leave it alone. Oh, get it. Oh, he fell for the shoulder. Go wide. Oh, no. Oh. Damn. What the hell? Oh, fuck it. This is getting intense. Third period, we're tied at 2. There's only about a minute left. And they're on a breakaway. Oh, God. Wait, that hit the post. It hit the post and it hit up. Hold up. Hold the fuck up. No, you gotta die. You gots to die. All I'm gonna say is that's what's gonna happen to you. You gotta come get your ass beat for that. Let me not fix this with a minute to go. I'ma fucking whoop your ass. Understand? There will be a cold day. Hell about to freeze. I want you to understand that hell is hot and I'm about to bring the liquid nitrogen for your to freeze your ass. I want you to know there's a place in hell for you. Now, if y'all score another goal, then we just fucking suck. But nah, fuck that. You hit the bar, bruh. Kiss my ass. You hit the fucking bar. I'll be damned. If I lose and it's on me, it's on me. Nah, bruh. We about to have a come to Jesus meeting. We about to have a come to goddamn Jesus meeting. And that's it. They got away with one. Ain't that fucking lovely? And that's the end of the first run, because we pretty much got bounced. Okay, what new skill do we have unlocked? Gas. We can repel players and objects. Unbelievable. Getting my ass beat is one thing. Getting my ass kicked is another thing. Losing on a goal like that. Y'all lucky this ain't football, because I would start turning into a river dancer on someone's back. Head over to my store and make it a permanent part of your pool skills. Now, the good news is this is a roguelike, so... yeah. We start at the beginning once again. But here's the cool thing. You know those pucks for every time we do cool and we do good? Well, this is when we bring our ass to the shop. And then we'll go to break after this when we go to the shop. And we have all these skills, you see? We can pull stuff up and get gas. We can get all these extra ones that are locked. But we got to find them during the game. We got these attributes. You know, to help our dude just be that little bit better. And I really think we might need to put some into some accuracy and some shot stuff. And then there's superstars over here. See, we could spend some money to get better superstars. Because Can Amber, he looked like he might indeed be the homie. We might be able to do something with him. So, we got something here. So, we're going to... actually, before we leave on break, we're going to go ahead and grab Cam Amber and see if we can't use him for our stuff. Because, yeah, there you go. Either way. That was fun. Hold on. I gotta find the fucking sound thing so I can mute it so I can play the ad music. There's the sound mixer. All right. But yeah, all right, so that in an hour or so, that in a nutshell is Tape to Tape Hockey. We're gonna come back, we're gonna do a second run because it seems like we have decent weather and I don't have to worry as much. I'm gonna go grab some fucking donuts and feed my cat. So I tell you guys what, you guys stay here, we'll be right back, we'll have more. All right, just stay there, and may the commercials ever be in your favor. Sir. Look at me. Look. Okay. So if you see somebody come around in a striped shirt, see, your mom doesn't know this, but I'm giving you full permission to bite them in the ass. You like meat, right? I'm letting you bite any and all referees you ever see in the ass, okay? I'll even throw one of your treats on for you. I'll give you 2 treats if you bite a referee in the ass. Maybe 5. Yeah, that sounds good to you, don't it? 5 treats. 5 treats to bite a referee in the ass. How do you feel about that proposition, sir? That's a verbal agreement if you see the lick. See, I'll give you 5 of them pig's ears. Yeah. See, your mom doesn't know that this deal exists. Okay. So look, I'm gonna teach you. See, you just gotta ang. You got You know how your mom always bites me in the arm? Yeah. Now do that. But do that to someone's ass. They'll never be able to sit down and be comfortable for the rest of their life. Do we have a deal, Cerberus? I'm happy you agreed. I'm happy that this agreement was signed before your mom found out anything about any of this. You are not to tell your mom, okay? Just if she asks, you just look cute. It'll distract her, okay? Okay. Okay, now I gotta close the door before your mom gets here. And you gotta stop balancing on my thigh, because I can't get to the door, and if I can't get to the door, I can't get your bribery treat.
Oh, really?
Hi. We were talking about very legal things and the future of Nerds of the Asylum. You know, almost as if we were, talking about business. Business propositions. You know, ad revenue splits. See, for every sub I get, he gets a treat. Bullshit. That's the proposition. Uh-huh. Yes. That's exactly what. What do you mean there's a clip? Son of a bitch. Cerberus, did you accidentally hit the back to stream button, buddy? How dare! See, now we can't do the deal, because now I'm going to fuck around and be on Dateline NBC or Nightline. I'm not going to be on To Catch a Predator, though, because last I checked, Wrong Dimension is north of 18, folks. So you ain't got to worry about that. Sir, give me a lick if you still want to thank you. Thank you. Good boy. Don't say nothing about that. There's no proof. Also, fuck y'all, that's circumstantial evidence with them clips. I'm not hearing it. Don't leave evidence. There is no evidence, what you talked about. Exactly, Michael. There's nothing that happened. Nothing. Not a goddamn thing. Yes, Kat, there was absolutely no evidence.
Uh-huh, wrong dimension.
Wrong Dimension, help me out here. I do the one thing with that you know, the lack of gag reflex, help me out here. What?
Sir, get him.
Not me, you're supposed to.
Get him.
Sir, buddy, what is this? All right.
By the way, the demon's trying to give the dog a treat.
Oh, okay.
Funny that she's a cat and she, like, heals. Say, whatever.
Alright, sir.
Gentle.
Ow. I'm just talking to the boy. I'm just telling him. Hey, sir. Why are you doing that?
Stripes.
Ow! Sir, you have 3 more treats!
Cerberus!
He's not coming back. He took 3. Because this is like super treats to him. So, like, he
that
just.
That counts as 3.
That counts as 3? Take it up with the mod. I didn't do it. Either way. Why is it a surprise? I don't think it's a surprise. Either way, what is a surprise is, hey, look, It's a roguelike that I actually enjoy and that apparently seems to even have the attention of Jonesy. The motherfucker can't stand roguelikes. At least what I remember. So far we've gotten an hour deep in. We got to the first boss and one, and I mean it, referees, the officials, the fighting zebras, if you will. Count your days. Count your motherfucking days. I will get back. And when I do, oh yes, there will be blood. You're lucky there ain't a fight. You're lucky that this is an early access game and there ain't no fighting. Otherwise, I'd turn this sumbitch into Philadelphia. You understand me? Count your days, officials. Count your days. But no, it's not bad. It's not bad. It's not a terrible game. Oh, well, that sucks, Jonesy. Oh, well. Either way. So we got another run going. We unlocked a guy. We got good shit going on. So, yeah, let's hurry up and get back to it before I forget. And before certain circumstantial evidence starts circulating around the internet, as it were. Cerberus is just flying around the goddamn house. The things you see around this channel, am I right, folks? Either way, let's get this paused. Let's get this paused, and let's get back to El Game-O-Rama. But yeah, well, are the rest of y'all at least enjoying the game? Because I'm even enjoying the game. It's going pretty well. Been fun so far. Good shit. All right, let's see. Activate once to launch the puck. Activate a second time to retrieve it. Nah, I ain't doing that one. Throw your stick to knock players down. Ooh, that's gonna be good. Oh! So it just adds them to the pool. Okay. So unlocking the players doesn't really do much. It's alright. Besides, I guess we went so... Angus will gain double benefits from resting at the campsites. Gain speed on a successful body check. Every great player grows against 10 checking. Let's do the double benefits. Let's see how that goes. Okay, so if I remember my build right, maybe we need to have a little bit more offensive. You know, some more offensive. Some offensive. Oh, right. Silly me, where are my goddamn manners? Every time I do a stream, I forget one thing. There we go. The music's back. Sorry about that, folks. We're good now. Let's end this early. Oh, just a bit outside. I want this game. I don't blame you. This is fucking good. I know right now it's $17.99. And yes, those of you that are wondering, this is that game that is the most recent review on the channel, which, damn, that review, it's already been a couple of months since I've done that one. So, good old Danny needs to go back to the lab again. And I'm knowing y'all, I probably need to do a review about a game that's not a hockey. Did I knock him out of his skates? He got knocked into the stands. I didn't know you could fucking do that. Oh, God, what an air shot. Was not expecting that, but yeah. They got their goal in, and that's our ass. We're not going to get a power up. They just lifted that one right over the fucking shoulder, too. Oof. You'd have thought with number three there, you'd have fucking jumped. You know, say it with your chest. Nothing. But, yeah. That does not bode well. But then again, we didn't get any shots on goal. We didn't... You talk about a sluggo start. That was not... It's no fucking bueno. Let's try the training. Let's see if this will, you know, help us out just a tad, just a little bit. But yeah, believe me, I can vouch for this game. It's one of two hockey games that I was extremely interested in. How the fuck did that not go in is beyond me. That I've been extremely interested in. The other one is called Hockey Heroes, and I'm just going to put it blunt. Oh, off the dump in. The goalie gives a rebound, and it's in. Okay. How do you let this in? I'm looking at my team. How does this get let in? How? How does the goalie not freeze this puck? How does he not catch this puck? That's some shit that'll put you on meme highlights for the rest of your goddamn career. Good Lord have mercy. That man is going to the minor leagues as we speak. But no, Hockey Heroes is, from what I saw about it, pretty much a hockey action RPG. So yeah, I don't know where the fuck these sports games decided to get creative, but keep it the fuck up. I'm down with it. Finally, we don't have to worry about just Madden all the goddamn time. We've got good shit coming down the pipes. That one went out of bounds. Hell, I think somebody's trying to crowdfund like a tactical RPG, but it's football. Or some shit, so like... God damn! That's a lot of grass. That is a lot of... Oh, bitch. They are really liking to clear the puck. They are very much a dump and chase team, I've noticed. Right now, they're dumping and we're chasing. And unless we get a goal in the next 5 seconds, which looks unlikely. Ooh, and that was almost in. God damn, this team is starting to suck. Madden has oversaturated the market. Honestly, I think it's actually the opposite with Madden. I think the fact that they have the exclusive license to the NFL is a problem. Because that's why we haven't had any form of competition. Because that's the real thing. They need competition. Because back in the 90s and back in the early 2000s, I can name like 5 or 6 different NFL games that had their fucking... That had their number. And that's a goal! We had that goalie's number. Like, there was game... Just not even the arcade shit. Game Day, Quarterback Club... NFL 2K, Konami had NFL Primetime, for fuck's sakes. And then there was a bunch of one and dones in the 90s. I think there was VR football. There was Konami with another football game. I think it was called NFL Full Contact. They weren't all great, but... And then you had the arcade shit like Blitz. So you had about 5 or 6 at any given time. But now it's just Madden. If you want to play, like, as the Saints and you don't want to mod it and you want it from the get-go, you fucked. And that is a goal! We're back up! Holy shit! That was a casual slap shot from near the top of the face-off circles, I think. Let me check again on the replay. Just a nice solid pass, past 37. Yep. A nice little deflection one-timer off of the goddamn top of the face-off circles. Beautiful. And then here's the thing, without competition, You have a straight up, you don't have any reason to innovate if you have no competition. That's the thing. And EA knew it. Because as soon as they got that damn thing with Madden 06, and they did the next, starting with like the next gen version. So since 05, that is three. That is a hat trick. Give it up. Oh, the bald people in the audience. Give them covers up. That is three goals for one dude. Hat trick city, baby. Just a nice pass. Another one-timer from the top of the face-off circle. The sweet spot. The big un. I think that might do it. Going off for three goals in about 30 seconds will probably put the game on ice, barring an incredibly stupid collapse of defense. Let's hope that don't happen. Oh, he's getting open again. Is he about to go Pavelski on us and go for four? Are we going to score four? Fuck, I'll take it. But that's the thing. And then here's the other thing. It's just all the innovation they have is Madden Ultimate Team. Which, if you know anything, that is four goals by the same guy in 1 minute. This motherfucker came to fuck your wives. Jesus. What a show. This game got turned right on its head. Side. It's all bruised. That's it. There's... This man put the entire team on his back in one goal. Turned it from a one goal down game to a 4-1 damn near blowout. One man. That was like some Liam Neeson shit right there. John Wick on ice, ladies and gentlemen. Does he got another one in him? He does not. But it's in anyway! Somebody else finally scored one. 5-1. That, if the first three goals were burying the other team, that fourth goal was the nail in the coffin. This is the cement that goes over the grave. Good night and goodbye. That's what I'm saying. So what I hope happens is somehow down the road, hell, even back in the day, fucking Nintendo. Oh wait. Did we just trigger the blowout clause? Because they didn't play the last 9 seconds. They just said, get your asses off the ice. That's game. Look at me being all mean and nasty on the ice, as it were. Life comes at you fast, don't it? But like I kind of wish we had the likes of Game Day and... Oh, and I also forgot, there were first party games like NFL Fever. Microsoft had its own games. So, Quarterback Club, Game Day, Fever. And those were the three majors. Quarterback Club, Game Day, Fever. What was the other one I just mentioned? 2K. So, every year you had at least four. You would usually have five with Quarterback Club. And then every now and again, you'd have some other people throwing in a random game. Hell, even Nintendo had a fucking football game at once. With the NFL license. So, like, that's the problem, is that there needs to be more competition. Or, honestly, I hate to say it, but unlike back in the day where, oh, fuck yeah, we got the license to the NFL, that's going to set our game apart. Some of the people that are fed up with Madden are just going to have to bite the bullet and just look at the indies. Because I've shown a multitude of, there's equivalents. What I like to call equivalent. Like, Legend, if you miss NFL 2K, get Legend Bowl. If you miss NFL Game Day, Sunday Rivals. If you miss NFL Blitz, how many times have I done Mutant Football League on this fucking channel? But yeah, like... So I feel like we need that in every major thing. Because NHL 23, at least for Xbox One, while not a bad game, it's been the same fucking game for years. The only reason why I'd even be interested in getting, like, maybe a copy of NHL 22 is, like, because the Seattle Kraken are there. But that's it. Like, there's really ain't no... there really ain't no like reason to just be like, yes, I want this. Cause like now it's like you got 1 year, you got them all. I mean, what's one major sports game that actually has something different this year? Maybe MLB The Show, but baseball is so fucking bad that, quite frankly, you got somebody that it got to the point where fucking MLB was like, all right, we'll make our own fucking game, and they had to make a deal to have Sony's game on Nintendo and fucking Xbox. So you do with that information what you will. Oh yeah, there is a lot to differentiate the genre. It's just for some reason when it comes down to licensed games, and I don't know if this is a symptom of the industry or what, I'm just a dude who likes video games, but it seems like a lot of AAA stuff doesn't hit anymore. And it seems like the stuff that does hit is like the indie stuff, because it feels like all the stuff that I want, except for maybe Nintendo. Like, if I'm going to get something day one, and I think this is probably also, like, because Kirby did good. But I think after the debacle of last year, those of you that were here for the road to Bayonetta 3 know exactly what I'm talking about. It's like, I'd rather spend $20 on a game like this. Well, I didn't spend $20. Cat spent $17.99, but you just follow me here. I'd rather spend a third of the price and feel like I get three times the game. You know what I'm saying? Like, because these indie motherfuckers just... And that's another thing that trips me out. And this isn't a shot to the devs. It's more to the publishers. How the fuck can a company, a AAA company, in this day and age, come out with such buggy-ass day one AAA games with hundreds of millions of dollars behind it, but an indie game can be like, look, it was the only people that coded was me, my best friend, and my dog accidentally put his paw on the thing and it fixed the glitch. Those were the three motherfuckers that coded this game. And it works like a goddamn charm. So I've seen some shit in early access from indie games work better than AAA games, and that's their launch. I don't know how the fuck that happens. But and that's the other thing that I've realized, and I feel bad because I was a part of the problem too. It ain't the devs. It's the fucking publishers. The devs are just doing their job. They're doing the best they can. It's the fucking publishers like, we need it out now. We need it out now. We need it out now. You have this date. Otherwise, fuck you. You drop what you're doing and it's going out regardless. Because they're the ones with the money. And like, I'm sorry for going on the tirade, and it might be considered a hot take, but yeah, it's just, I feel like it's a symptom of the times. It used to be where about maybe not 20 years ago, maybe even 10 years ago, that, you know, budget games used to be the fucking like $2.99 Wii game made cheap that nobody except for a 62-year-old grandma at a Walgreens that's trying to desperately find something for their kid would buy. Nowadays, budget games are the motherfuckers. Like, they put so much into their shit, it's not even funny. Like, and here's a perfect example of it. Pizza Tower. I may not be good at platformers, but that game, for what I've seen, tight controls, good everything. Games like this. Games like... Ooh, God, I'm going on a tangent, ain't I? I'm sorry for going on a tirade, but then again, maybe I shouldn't apologize, because maybe some of you are here for that sort of thing. But, like, that's the thing, is, there is innovation out there. It just, a lot of people, and I know some people are like, oh, well, I don't want to play indie games, then you're kind of fucking stuck with, then I hope to God Nintendo becomes innovative and do some cool shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta kind of dip. And you gotta get off the beaten. This isn't a shot at anyone here, but I've seen it on Twitter where people will be like, I shouldn't have to play indie games to get a different experience. I'm like, bruh, y'all with fucking Sony making money off of consoles, Xbox making money off of consoles, Activision making money off of fucking Call of Duty and all the skins that go with that, and EA making money off of Madden and all the Ultimate Team shit that goes with that, if you're not making money, they ain't gonna give a fuck. When's the last time y'all heard about an update for Lost in Random? And that might have been the most recent game that, and even then, EA published it. They ain't make it. That's what I'm getting at. Is that y'all, people have to learn that if y'all really want to say, if y'all are really tired of AAA shit, y'all are tired of them fucking your game up, you're tired of them giving you fucked up shit on launch, starters, how about y'all not buy the motherfucker? And secondly, maybe just check out an indie or two, because they'll probably have what you need or what you want. I've learned that shit. You know, don't judge a book by its cover. Because I think I've even seen someone that there's a new Super Mega Baseball game that are coming out, and they're like, oh, I'm tired of the show. But then they're clowning on them because, oh, these graphics suck. Like, graphics are the end-all, be-all of games. I didn't know we were still in 2001. fucking hell. Look at this. This game ain't even full 3D, but the damn mechanics are crisp, smooth, good, all that jazz. I'm about out of clips again. God damn. I must be doing good if you're running out of fucking clips. But that's the thing, is that you gotta go off the beaten path. Y'all wonder why all these, like, retro games that are, like, hidden gems that people say or whatever, or the rarest fuck ones? Those are the games that back in the day, people wouldn't look at because they weren't the biggest, most indie-ass game, you know, most AAA-ass game in the world. But nowadays, it's like, there's no excuse with digital distribution and all that shit. The shit is cheap. Like, hell, there's a basketball game right now for $9.99 called, like, Street Step or something. And that shit plays like NBA Jam, but anime from what I've seen. You damn right, if I can get the money for it, I might fucking do it. But at the same time, don't shun it. Like, you get what I'm saying. Yeah, sometimes you gotta just scout. If something you like, check out a YouTube review. Check out my YouTube review. Same shameless self-promotion. Like, that's what's gotta happen. Yeah, exactly. But that, like, if you've seen the Super Mega Baseball games, they're kind of cartoonish, but they have these really good things. And he was like, oh, they better not have DLC if the graphics are going to look like this. I'm like, this might be the most solid sports game that EA Sports brings out in 10 fucking years. And you going fucking bitch because the graphics don't look realistic. Did the Order 1886 not point anybody to the thing of, it doesn't fucking matter if the graphics are realistic, if they ain't worth the fuck? How many PS2 games ain't worth the shit? Because, oh, the graphics are so fucking realistic, but the gameplay ain't worth a damn. If you got... Damn. Speaking of ain't worth a damn, hey, goalie, my boy, what was that? Homie.
Explain yourself.
Another one... And you got there in time. How did you fuck that up? Do I gotta, like, put Velcro on your jersey? Exactly. Like, none of the games that I have are... Not all of them are gonna win Graphics of the Year. And they really shouldn't. And hell, and I'll be the one to say it. And hell, that's why a lot of people go to retro games, because they're complete and all that type of stuff. And another thing... If you have a retro game and you like it and it's $300 and there's no other way and nobody's re-released it, just emulate the goddamn thing. Depending on which era it's in, motherfucker, you are protected by abandonware. Just go on ahead and get it over with. If Sega ain't gonna re-release the shit, just go ahead and play the motherfucker so you can have a good time. Because, look, modern gaming, to an extent, is there some good things? Are there some good AAA games? I'm sure of it, yeah. But at this point, fuck it. Because right on cue. But the way things are going with modern gaming, AAA ain't going to be affordable soon. And also, because they're already starting that $70 thing, and then a lot of... And then, as if none of them... Ooh! 2 goals in 5 seconds! Almost as if... It's almost like anybody in video games didn't take economics. Because... Because everybody's like, oh, there's new reports coming out that all these games that are at that are priced at $70 aren't selling as well. And it's like, yeah, you charged more for a game. Of course there's going to be less, homie. Like, what you expect? You jacked up the price. A lot of people stopped going to McDonald's. Once they jacked that... You know how many people bitched about the McDonald's fucking McDouble going from $1 to $1.49? You thought people weren't going to bitch about video games going up 10 extra dollars? Get the fuck out of here. It's nothing but unabashed greed. That's the same, and I've went on this tirade before. It's the same reason why they put out the Xbox One, the Xbox Series S, the Xbox Series X, and the PS5 during the pandemic, knowing damn well ain't nobody was going to have the money for it. Thus turning the last 3 years into nothing more than a glorified fucking beta test for the fucking new consoles. I'm just saying. Because that, and also, last time that, you know, economy and shit wasn't that great, that's why the PS3 was like, had a 10-year lifespan and the 360 had a 10-year fucking lifespan. I know this is supposed to be about hockey, and if the tape-to-tape guys are here, I do apologize. Your game is fucking great. Please don't take this tirade the wrong way. I've gushed about your game before, and when it's officially released, I'll gush about it again, because games like this is the shit that keeps gaming fun. Games like this is what keeps shit great, because it's affordable and all that jazz. This is what fucks. That's what I'm saying. I think I bored Kat with that rant. Either that or she's like, no, Danny, you got a good head on your shoulders. I don't know which, but I'm just over here like, I hope to God I haven't bored y'all. Speaking of boring, this game hasn't been. We're tooth and nail. We're in sudden death overtime, folks. But that's the thing. That's why you see a lot of people going, because it used to be where nobody gave a fuck about old games because the PS2 era, the PS3 era. We had solid fucking games. PS4 and 5, it's like, you know, you pay $60 and you pay another fucking $10 for DLC and another $10 for DLC. And don't get me started on fighting games that started charging by the motherfucking fighter. You wonder why there are barely any fighting games on this fucking channel? Like, why the fuck? How the fuck is Mortal Kombat? Like, I could call Mortal Kombat out, but I ain't really trying to deal with the fighting game community because them motherfuckers can beat me by the power of smell alone, because they don't take showers. But anyway, we're heading to an era where we're going to get pinned up. That's the thing. I feel like it's happening everywhere in a lot of different things where the little middle thing is getting squeezed out, because there's going to come a time where I like Kirby. I mean, Nintendo is even charging $70, which isn't helping, because I mean, if they're gonna do that, can y'all bring back the 1999 Player's Choice games? Cause we ain't gonna afford this $70 shit. It's how it is. There's going to be a lot of us that pretty soon y'all are gonna be playing. Well, I'm not saying as a doer, but the AAA games that you guys like, unless that shit comes on Game Pass. It's either going to come to two things. Either everybody's going to be on a subscription service, or the people that aren't on a subscription service are going to be like, all right, I'm going to buy like maybe one or two AAA games, and the rest of my shit's going to the cheaper games. And we've been eliminated. Can Amber with the one-timer right next to the line, next to the goalie crease. The Forbidden Land, as I brought up Kirby. Ain't that a bitch? Just a good deflection. There was nothing he could do. And that's the other thing. It's just... the quality's the one to shit. I don't know why the quality went to shit. But it's just... if y'all... The way the future of games is going... Everybody... And I know a lot of you in this channel. And I don't mean this to take a shot at you. It's not like this channel... has the budget of insert popular streamer here or insert popular game company that does shit like Screw Attack used to here. money ain't flowing, you know what I'm saying? So, like, shit's tough. And it's just, and with money not going as far as it used to, quite simply, folks, games like this, games like Tape to Tape, games like Pizza Tower, games like Disgaea, a lot of indie fucking games, Cow the Kangaroo, a lot of these games are gonna be the thing that makes you go, like, or whenever I did the cool games for Halloween, like, y'all remember Pumpkin Jack? ActRaiser, a lot of these games that are going to be 40 and under are probably going to be the games that a lot of people look at, because ain't nobody got money for $500 consoles on top of, you know, 80, 70, and then you fucking know EA or Ubisoft, one of them two bastards are going to try and push it, and they're going to try and come out with a $75 or $80 game. Which, honestly, at this fucking point, if AAA, like, the pessimist in me says that all this shit is gonna lead to another video game crash. That's what the pessimist in me says. You know what I mean? Like, there's gonna be this big-ass downturn, and it's just gonna collapse on itself. Because everything that gets too big does collapse on itself. I mean, it's happened before. I'm not going to say it because I ain't going to break my own fucking rule. But you get what I mean. And I'm sorry for the long-winded thing. Well, goddamn, did I really? How long did I rant for? 20 minutes? Shit. How do y'all put up with me? I would ask how do y'all put up with me, but some of y'all have been agreeing with what I was saying. So for once, I'm not going to be as self-defeatist as I usually am. Like, there's a lot of reasons why there's still PS2 games and Xbox games on the shelf. There's reasons why I'm still doing Tony Hawk, but on the same time, there's reasons why I still scout the indies. You know what I mean? Because that's probably going to be, because of the way AAA games are, because also, here's the thing, with that much money behind it, it's going to be safe. If you want the kind of weird, zany, out there shit, you got two fucking options. You hope Nintendo does it, or you hope, like, Activision tries to bring back somebody for 2 minutes before they send their ass to the Call of Duty mines. You know what I mean? Like, gaming is, it feels like gaming's at a crossroads. Do I know where it's gonna go? Fuck no. No, I don't. I mean, E3's dead because Geoff goddamn Keighley Knightley. I don't fucking care. I ain't getting his name right. I don't like the motherfucker. I don't care if I said that on stream. What's gonna happen to me? He gonna knock my damn door down with Mountain Dew and Doritos or something? He gonna tell me to fucking vote for Hideo Kojima at the Game Awards? I don't fucking care. It's just, the state of games kind of fucking sucks. I swear to you, and you can ask Wrong Dimension, I've played more games with Wrong Dimension on the Sega Genesis pack that we have than we did on anything else that's not Minecraft. And when it comes down to graphics, you want another game that me and Kat been playing as of late? Fucking Stardew Valley. Stardew Valley looks like a fucking overgrown Super Nintendo game, but it's fun. I like fucking mining, doing all the mining, beating the slimes, and fishing. I fuck with the fishing on that game. Apparently, I'm just good at fishing. The more you know what I'm saying? But it's just, it feels like if you want, it just feels like games at a crossroads, because if you want all the artistic, like, oh, this is going to totally get turned into a movie type games, yeah, AAA. But if you want fun, oh, yo, bring your ass to the indies. And that's not an absolute, because there's going to be some indies that are kind of like the prestige thing. And then there's going to be some fun AAA games, maybe. But I get what y'all are saying, but that's why I always go out of my way to make sure this channel has some indie on it at least once a month. I would love to have that. That's why I try and do all the reviews that I can and show all these dope-ass retro games and dope-ass indie games, because There's good shit out there. And I want you guys to play it however you fucking can. If that means getting it on a Steam sale and it's 90% off because you finally got the money for it, bet. If that means you get it, if you get off this stream now and go buy Tape to Tape, bet. And in some cases, when I play a retro game, if y'all play it on emulator, fine, go ahead. Motherfucker, I might be playing it on emulator too. You think I got $300 fucking dollars for some of them Saturn games? Hell no. That's the thing, and it feels like the that's the one thing with AAA games. Just feels like along the way they lost their fun. I think the last first party PS1 game that I got, that I don't even know if this is considered AAA because it's from them, but eh. Y'all remember the Medieval remake from like 2019? That's the last one I got. A lot of AAA games feel the same to me, so I just take walks on the dark side, as it were. It is what it is. Whew, that was a lot. God damn. Need a drink. Shit. So, those of you that survived to the end of this tirade, actually... Let me go ahead and not be rude and let me see what some of y'all said. FromSoft doesn't do it anymore after Dark Souls 2. I could verify they had to overhaul the whole fucking game after 2 years later to fix it. That's a point. Let's see. The graphics for Oregon Trail suck ass. Hella popular. You're right. We're here for a good time, not for a long time. Might as well enjoy it. They did, but they don't care. They're greedy fucks. Yeah. Okay, so it seems like the temperature of the water is it's not ice cold. But yeah, no, and going back to your thing, Jonesy, I think we've hit the point where the Triple H on the dark side. Yeah, because like I like NHL 23. I love NHL, of course, but I mean, I wouldn't have mind 2K coming back. I wouldn't have mind at the bare minimum having hits and fucking I mean, stuff like that, which is why I'm happy that there's developers. We have Tape to Tape. We're going to get Hockey Heroes, which for my hockey fans, y'all remember Wayne Gretzky's 3D hockey? It's like that, but an RPG from what I've heard, and I'm down with it. It's just some got to give, but that's why I'm like, at the bare minimum, that's why you see, once everybody starts hyping up an indie, that's when you start seeing me go, how you doing? You know what I mean? Because where there's smoke, there's fire. And if everybody likes it well enough, there's got to be something there. But that's the thing. It's just with AAA games, I don't know what the fuck's going on no more. I don't know. But it seems like if you want just pure fucking fun that won't break your goddamn wallet, and DLC that doesn't feel like they chopped half the fucking game off and just gave you half and waited for later. And if you guys want updates particularly fast, y'all might want to check out indies. And I'll advocate for the indies all the live long day, because it's not like what we also need, like we had back in the day, is that the other thing that sucks is the HD era, the mid-2000s. Now, granted, this wasn't... Partially, it's because of the way games change, and partially it was because their own fuck-ups. But we don't have those mid-level developers no more. You know what I'm saying? We don't have we don't have Midway. We don't have Acclaim. You know what I'm saying? We don't have the ones that weren't really, you know, the big motherfuckers, but weren't like some rando ass. We ain't got them no more. We ain't got like Majesco and shit like that. The people that did Blood Rain. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, like, all we got right now is just AAA and indie. It used to be AAA, AA, single A, indie. The middle of the game thing, just PS3 mode, boom, gone. Midway may have been the one that lasted the longest out of everybody I'm talking about. First goal of the game is worth two. But don't mind if I do, baby. Probably going to do another run of this, and yeah, we have Digital Extremes. Can't discount Unreal Tournament. Tango with Hi-Fi Rush. Hi-Fi Rush, I thought was from Bethesda. So I was like, yeah. Also, if that's considered AAA, that's the last one I had fun with. I don't even like rhythm games like that, and that's not because rhythm games suck. No, it's because I'm a tone-deaf son of a bitch. I mean, I'll be out here doing the calls today, so, you know what I'm saying? that's a me problem. But Tycoon no Tatsujin? Well, I'll fuck with that. Well, yeah, no. I wouldn't count on real Digital Extremes, so no. But even then, we can't buy Unreal no more. Epic made sure of that. So, like, I don't know if I'm gonna count that. But, like, because, like, I'm trying to better phrase it, but it was, like, back in the day, you had motherfuckers just... I'm trying to figure out how to put it, because I'm trying to find historical examples of exactly what I'm talking about. Like... Oh, come on, baby. Come on, baby. Got him. Oh, I thought I had him. But, like, the best two I could think of is Midway and Acclaim. Because, yeah, Acclaim had some stuff like Turok, but you know and I know that shit. Mm-mm. They also used to put out licensed games like a summoner bitch. Trying to think. Who else could be considered? Maybe early Ubisoft? Lionshead was... I thought Lionshead would have been considered AAA, too. Because, like, they'd have been a part of Microsoft Game Studios, and that's a first-party studio, so... Auto-biggin. You know what I'm saying? Paradox? LucasArts would be that little bit of a middle ground, because they'd have, like, their Star Wars shit would be AAA, but everything else would just be like, hey, here a good $39 game, you know? I mean, technically, in an extreme case, for like 1 year only, 2K Sports was like that, because they remember them sports games? Fucking ESPN NFL 2K5 was $19.99, which made it the certified broke bastard classic, because that was just good. And that's another thing. Would it kill the... And this is another gripe. Here's the thing, and this is probably going to be a hot take. I'd be down... If they're gonna do $70 stuff, fine. But you got to do something friendly to the consumer. By that I mean is, if y'all are gonna fucking do the $70 thing, then y'all got to bring back Greatest Hits, Player's Choice. What I'm saying is, you got to start bringing back them budget classics. Y'all got to stop Nintendo. If you're gonna do Tears of the Kingdom and all your other games for $70, then I better see all them launch repackaged Wii U games that are Switch games for $19.99. You better do it, and you better do it quickly. PS4, I'm looking at you. Break out the Greatest Hits, my brother. It's time to go. Time for me to get them. Time for you to put God of War at $9.99 digitally and physically. Don't get slick and try and do that fucking put it 60 in the goddamn eShop. Nah, bro. It's time. I don't know where they got to be stingy hoes like that, but they need to cease. Woo, shit. Dragon's Dogma sequel confirmed. And we've got a goal, baby. Send them home. But yeah, like, it's just... Is a lot of it just the cost of doing business? I'm sure. I'm going to be real with you. A lot of the shit that happens with AAA games feels like unabashed greed that they know that blind fanboys will defend them for. Which, by the way, folks, don't... If there's nothing worse to one's intellect than console fanboyism. Don't do that shit. Don't do that shit. I may have loved Sega as a kid, but don't do that shit. Come on now, folks. Like, that ain't the way... But also, New Dragon's Dogma, I will keep my eye on it. But no, like that middle fucking tier. Because it feels like a lot of people either just died. That middle tier back in the day either died. Like, who the fuck would be considered middle tier now? 505 games, maybe? Like, maybe Devolver? Devolver might be considered that like, double A, that mid-tier. And I know 505 is weird as fuck. I got a couple of 505 games over here for PS3. One of them is called Backbreaker. It's a physics-based football game. When does hype become fanboyism? When it becomes toxic tribalism? When you start you can be hyped for Zelda, but when you start thinking that your company can do no wrong and every other company can't do right, you gotta stop. You know what I'm saying? That's when you start going too far. Like, appreciate the games, appreciate the console for what it is. But, you know, if someone says, and if they do it respectfully and they go, hey, like, case in point, me with Nintendo games, Fire Emblem, at least the more recent shit, and to an extent Smash, ain't really my cup of tea. I'm a Yoshi Kirby playing motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Now, truly, I'm an alternative Nintendo kid. I grew up playing King Griffey, Kobe Bryant, fucking F-Zero, and 1080 Avalanche. Like, that was my shit. Like, racing and all that stuff. Like, yeah, boy, I'm with it. Relogic, I think, is that border. 505 and Devolver, yeah. But Relogic, with it still being one dude and they still doing Terraria, I kind of leave. You being hype, yeah, be hype. Enjoy your shit. But it's not like you're going, man, fuck every other game. It's Dragon Age and Mass Effect, Supremacy, blah, 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 blah. You know, or better yet, you go on Twitter and everybody that likes Sony is calling people Xbox, and everybody that likes fucking Xbox is calling Sony motherfuckers Sony ponies and all that shit. Like, that ain't the way. Like, don't get me wrong. Do I like the old commercials from the 90s with the Genesis and does when Nintendo don't? Supergiant, I can see that. Like, the commercials fucking rocked, you know, at least from an art standpoint, but it's just marketing hype. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was kind of fun to see the companies go at each other, but then when you see, like, homeboy down the street, because it's like, these companies don't give a fuck about you like that. If they start giving a fuck about you, that means you either pirated something or the check didn't bounce. And if they start giving a fuck about you like that, you ain't gonna like the fact they're giving a fuck about you. You understand what I'm saying? So it's just, because, I mean, me, I like Midway. Well, I loved Midway. I'm a widow now. When I was a kid, Crystal Dynamics, because I guess I can get more use out of this gag, but the Gex games, for fucking example. exactly, because it feels like at some point we lost the whole just have fun. I mean, if you want to play on Xbox, you want to play whatever, have fun. At this point, I don't give a fuck if you want to play on an Atari Jaguar or a 3DO. Just have fun and just, like, if you have fun with your stuff, that's cool. But you don't have to make yourself feel better about what you bought by going over to somebody else and being an ass about it. And I can say the same thing about pro wrestling, too. That AEW versus WWE shit gets on my fucking nerves every day of the fucking week. You just want to slap the shit out and be like, shut up and enjoy the wrestling. You know, you like, y'all remember Eddie Murphy Raw? And Eddie was like doing the thing where he's like, well, I talked to Richard Pryor, and he was like, tell him I said have a coke and a smile and shut the fuck up. That's pretty much what I want to hear. Like, and here's the thing. Bruh, if Sega comes back to the console market, I will camp. Let's put it this way. I would camp out in front of a GameStop so much that Kat would literally have to be like, bitch, come home. And, like, sling me over her shoulder. But even then, I'd be like, hey, Sega back. Yeah. I wouldn't be like, fuck every other console. Sega's back. Like the shit, it's absurd. It's utterly absurd. And it just... it baffles the mind that people will be here. And then there's some people that'll just defend every fucking thing the company does, good or bad. You have Nintendo motherfuckers talking about, oh, well, $70 makes sense. I'm like, maybe on a PS5 game, I guess. But the Nintendo, every time I open up the Nintendo eShop, I think my Switch about to blow up. The fuck you mean y'all need 10 extra dollars? You broke bastards. Stop it. But like, and then so many people be like, well, actually, we don't really need backwards compatibility because why are you playing old games anyway? Because they good. Y'all, you still watch old movies. Y'all still watch Scarface. Some of y'all motherfuckers still watch Casablanca. Just because it's old don't mean it sucks. You talking to a motherfucker that got Saturn games up there. I got a goddamn, I got a stack of 32X games in this motherfucker. Of course I'm going to say, look, if it's good, it's good. You know what I'm saying? Ah, shit, wrong dimensions clipping again. Must mean I'm going on another tirade, folks. Like, matter of fact, not only do I still watch classic Disney movies, I'm about to do two things here. Hold on, let me see. Not only do I still watch classic Disney movies, motherfuckers. Wait, actually. Yeah, that's right, I can get props, goddammit. Not only can I still watch classic Disney movies, God damn it, I can still play classic Disney movies. Literally, can still play classic Disney. You know what I'm saying? Just right here. Oh, also, hey, y'all wanna see me scare Wrong Dimension real quick? Ooga booga booga, son of a bitch, it's the Lion King! I ain't shit. Also, those of you that are new here, welcome to the channel. I'm Danny DeMonica, and I have apparently been a walking head case tonight just playing hockey. I do appreciate y'all showing up. Second hour already. All right, I got maybe one. Once this run is done, hella high water, then it's wrapped. Oh, this rant got my throat dry. Hell, you know, Crystal Dynamics, before they got bought by Eidos, I think that would be a good, like, question of a AA, AAA type person, because they had Gex, they had the one big one with Tomb Raider, and they just had a bunch of solid shit. They weren't AAA, but they were, no, that, they had Gex, Tomb Raider, all that shit. One of these days, you're going to have to play it. Yeah, maybe. But I value my sanity, so why would I do it willingly? You better hope the Wheel of Misfortune fucking picks it for me. Otherwise, I ain't doing that shit. What little sanity I have left gonna be out the window. I'm gonna be over here like, that one level. Having non-flashbacks about the goddamn giraffe level and getting the monkeys to throw me the right way. I'll be over here like, the pattern. The pattern never changes. But no, like, that's the thing, and that's what I feel like, because, you know, everybody's like, oh, I want video games to be art. Which, okay, that would be dope. Video games can look great and still be fun. How do you do, Okami? You know what I'm saying? Like, it feels like, and this is going to be, you know, a hot take, but that's probably part of the reason why I've never had any interest in The Last of Us, because it felt more like, for motherfuckers that didn't like games, I guess. Slash motherfuckers that, you know, more story than gameplay. It never felt like something that clicked with me. And that's just a personal thing. If you like The Last of Us, hey, more power to you. And I ain't trying to take nobody's knees out with that comment. It's just, the shit ain't for me. It kind of just reminds me of, hey, games used to be fucking fun. Now, granted, the advancement of storytelling in games, that's cool, but not at the sake of fucking gameplay. That's why I didn't like fucking, what's it name? Telltale Games. It just reminded me that I was over here just, it felt like I was taking a multiple choice exam, and I kind of left that shit alone when I graduated college. You know what I'm saying? Okay. The wrestling thing made me think of Aki in the Def Jam series as Triple H. Thank you for reminding me that THQ used to exist. That might be the best example of a double A motherfucker. I mean, have y'all ever seen Tacking the Power of motherfucking Juju? A triple A company would not have come out with no goddamn Tacking the Power of Juju. Yeah, baby! Light up that lamp for double points. I need to direct you to something in Skyrim. THQ Nordic. Back in the day, they were just THQ. And back in the day, depending on how you knew them, you either knew them for taking the last EA Sports games on Super Nintendo and Genesis and publishing them, or if you're a wrestling fan, No Mercy, WrestleMania 2000, SmackDown versus Raw. Like, they took over from Acclaim, and they, or for the WCW fans, oh, another goal, baby. That's El Hattrick. But it's just the way shit has been going with how companies have been. It's just, I'm saying this from my standpoint in this channel. There ain't gonna be too many $60 games being on this channel. Like, Metroid Prime Remastered is $40, homie. I'll do that. That's it. Like, it's gonna be indie games like it used to be. Cause, I mean, I can justify $20. I can't. Ooh! I can justify that gold, though. God damn! Another one-man wrecking crew game. That first goal counted as two, so this is the hat trick right here. Three physical goals, but 4 points. It be a spicy meatball just right off the little edge of the face-off circle. Beautiful. Got him, ran off of the ice. They're going to call the game. 4-0 is your winner. Woo! I'm out here filibustering, and I'm still whooping ass on hockey. Ugh. My fat ass gonna grab another donut just to cope my throat scratching. But no, like, I mean, fuck sakes. I feel like this is just gonna be the start of me doing more indie games, the occasional AAA, which is more than likely gonna be the Nintendo game, and like the rest of it be stuff that you see on the shelf. You know what I mean? Like, because now I want to do all three of the Gex games. Well, maybe two of the three, because I can deal with 2D platforming. It's 3D platforming that get me a little worried. You know what I'm saying? Whew. Thank y'all for going through another tirade with me. I appreciate the hell out of that. 13 viewers. God damn, y'all. Either, I don't know if it's the tirades or it's the hockey game, but I appreciate all y'all being around. It warms the soul. Which way do I want to go? Let's do the challenge. Because let's really get into the meat and potat. But yeah, like, I think what's the next game I'm going to get that's probably going to be like $60? Probably going to be AEW Fight Forever, but even then, I'm going to wait and see the reviews because your boy ain't getting burnt. And did I go? Oh, it didn't go in. I mean, we're getting good chances, just not going in. But yeah, I'll totally take a look at it here in a sec. Probably after stream. And probably after Stardew Valley and watching more Unicorn Warriors Eternal with my boyfriend, because that shit fucks. That show fucks, not gonna lie. But no, 15? 15 viewers. Shit, had I known that, I'd have broke out the extra makeup and maybe even the good china. We gonna have so many guests over. How y'all doing? Should I just do more tape to tape on next Saturday in action? And that's a goal, baby. Get it on in. Give me my reward, baby. Because we need all we can get to them referees, because them referees going to pay. Ever wanted to whack someone with a tankard? Yes. Hell, there's a couple of referees I still want to beat the shit out of. Get, yeah, it's cool. What can you do with a drunken motherfucker? Bitch slap him, of course. Now, he going to send me into Skyrim looking like New Jack from ECW. Ain't that some shit? Oh, God. But no, games like this, it just taps into the fun factor vein. Because that, back in the day when I was a kid, that's what I used to grade games on. Like, I would go, I'd read GamePro magazine. As soon as I saw that fun meter at 5 out of 5 or like 4 out of 5, oh, it's on. You know, like, come to daddy. Good old Danny about to have him some fun, baby. You know what I'm saying? Have the fastest passes on the island? Praise the mad god, that mod is hilarious. But yeah, like... I will say, because I gotta let my throat rest a little bit, I appreciate some of y'all that came around for my impromptu TED Talk about the state of the games industry. Support your indies. Emulate retro games. Thank you. And somebody go tell Warner Brothers Interactive Entertainment that they got Gauntlet, and I need a Gauntlet Dark Legacy remastered. Gauntlet Legends remastered. Just put it in my veins, baby. Y'all ain't doing shit else with it. The only thing y'all remember that exists is fucking Mortal Kombat. And, well, come on. Y'all bought Midway. Do something with it. I gotta bounce. My phone's dying. It's been real. All right. See you, Jonesy. Ooh, till the wheels fall off. That's a good goal. Celebrate. Celebrate out here looking like a blonde Jack Nicholson. Woo! Yeah, but no, that's what I'm saying. They got all the goddamn IPs from Midway. Nothing. All I got was Gauntlet Slayer Edition, which it's all right, but when you can't go back to the... After playing, like, Dark Legacy, and even Seven Sorrows, you can't go back to that. Like, if they could just care about something that doesn't have Shadow of Mordor in it, or, you know, LeBron James fighting somebody, or whatever. You know, Space Jam, A New Legacy, the fighting game. That's what Multiverses is, pretty much. But, like... They have so much cool shit. I mean, either give up the IP or let somebody do something with it. Come on now. We got too much shit going on for you to just be like, no thanks. I'm not going to make a new Robotron 2084. I'm just going to sit here on my... Like, that's the reason why a lot of people don't know about the classics, because they won't re-release the classics. Well, I mean, they will re-release the classics, but in like a little package. Like in the 90s. In early 2000s, motherfuckers re-release and made a new thing a Pong, for fuck's sakes. Oh, thanks for the sub. Thank you very much. Like, you get what I'm saying? It just... Oh, thanks for the follow. What I ain't about to thank is the fact that they just scored on me. That sucks. Come on, but there we go. Good thing that first goal counted for two, otherwise we'd be in a little bit of a predicament. But no, it's just... God! Ah, well, there we go. That's what I worried about right there. Ugh. I have talked like, this is the most that I have talked in a few streams now. Woo! At some point, you just wind up just, my lungs, my throat, it's drier than the Sahara Desert. we just gonna have to go into overtime. Woo! Oh god, that's the second overtime game this run? It seems like. Ugh. I'm over here just nervous as shit. Okay. Overtime. I'm also just slowly letting myself chill, but there's just. Oh! Grand opening, grand closing, good night. That'll do it. Thanks for coming, folks. We just needed a little bit extra seconds. That's all. Just a nice one-timer pass, deflected off the defender, and tapped on in for the game winner, baby. We still doing overtime? Wait, we still doing overtime? I thought it was sudden death. It ain't sudden death? Are y'all not entertained? The fuck? Sorry, I'm a little perturbed, confused. What the hell? Oh, they are letting him have the puck too damn long now. I mean, do y'all want me to go up two goals and send them home? I can do that. That was mean. That was mean. Damn, they really saying, nah, you gotta keep playing. The corpse is dead. You want it a third time? And this is why I'm saying, y'all, bruh, why did you do that? You really let it off your bouncer. You let it off the blocker pad. God help me. That is the last goal you let up. Because we can't have no more of this. Damn, that was a violent ass slap shot. God damn. Oh, tipped. If they somehow tie this up, my whole team about to get traded. I wouldn't care if it's for 7th round picks or less. Everybody got to go at that point. Be a liquidation sale, goddammit. Oh, that hurt my soul because I knew that was going in. Just once you hear that tink, you just go, oh, damn. Whew. And we'll escape with one. That was closer than it needed to be. It's a good thing we won all of overtime, apparently. Thanks, game. I'm thinking I'm about to be like, GG, good fun. We out. See ya. No, that game said, nobody. I would like to play. Oh, thanks for the follow. See? Indie games. Makes you feel good inside. Whew. All right, we're gonna rest. Forward all for all to all the players. Alright, time for me to try and whoop the referee's ass one more again. Whew. Okay, we've seen all this. Alright, so do or die. I'm just over here like, no. I'm getting my vengeance against the boss right now. I'm just looking at my goalie like, buddy, what are you doing? Okay, miss the hit. Up top near the damn blue line and just let it in. Like, I know your homeboy was out there, but throw an elbow out or something. Come on. Help me help you, homeboy. Help me help you. I sure as hell tried to do that off the damn bounce. Did not work, but okay. There you go. Come on. There you go. I'm over here just like that. Did the hockey puck just go for a ride on the top of the wall again? It happens a lot in this game. There you go. Nice and tied up. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just a nice pass. He got free of the other guy and right there. Right at the top. I swear it's that faith. It's right at the top of the face-off circle. Perfect. Oh, that only counted for one? Oh, okay. First goal counted for two except against the boss? I ain't know all that. Oh, they scored two. They scored first, so it's a double-edged sword goal. Cool. Okay, so we're down one. That's all right. Maybe we can lull them into a false sense of security? Or knock the fuck out of a goalie. That's cool, too. Oh, buddy, get off the ground. God damn. I was like, screw it, let the damn slap shot fly and nothing doing. So we're down one after one. Cool. God damn. I see why people don't talk so much on stream. Fucking hell. Need more goddamn water. Jesus. Hydrate before you die, what you think I'm doing? Oh, we just gonna get our whole entire ass beat. Alright. Alright, let's check this damn goal. What did we do wrong here? Okay. Well, we let him have control of the zone, which doesn't fucking help. What is with my goalie missing? Buddy, you keep this shit up. Minor leagues. The lower room. Good lord. But yeah, now that I'm done with that ginormous ass tirade, how's everyone else's night going? Whew, okay. Shit, I might play a little bit more of this off stream. My curiosity is piqued. At least I hope to God I can beat the boss on stream, but damn, we might need to do this a few, little bit more often. Your goalie ain't shit, but neither is theirs. Right? God damn, why half the team laying down? Hey! Get y'all ass. Hey, wait a minute now. Wait a goddamn minute now. Hold on, the puck is right there. I know my goalie blocked that one. Yo, Stevie Wonder, you want me to fucking punch you in the ear and make you Helen Keller too? I see, you know what? I know damn well y'all probably fucked that goal up because you too much of a bitch to replay it. This might be our team's ass though. Come on, get wide. I said you to get wide. I did not mean the puck to go wide, my man. There you go. That's how you do it. We coming back, goddammit. We're coming back. I don't know how the fuck you just flipped that one in, but I appreciate you. Oh, that's off the face-off. Off of the stick, or was it the shoulder of a referee? And in. Off the rebound. Shit, I ain't complaining. Come on, my boy, get open. Yeah, there you go. That's right. Ty, you ain't getting rid of me that easy, goddammit. Woo, another one-timer. Now that one just got blazed past the goalie and he was just like, which way did it go, George? Which way did it go? You like how it's Sin Bin Stadium? You ain't wrong, it is sick. Once again, oh, that was in! Or did it not go in? We tied at 4 now. Like I said, y'all better pull a miracle out your ass because this is indeed your ass. Come on, boys. What you gonna do? Did you just throw the puck? Bruh, man, when can you use your hands in hockey like that? Hold up. I checked the Hockey Brochure now. I've been reading that bitch since 1999. Hold the fuck up. Hold on. Wait a minute. I do declare that's some bullshit. Where we going? Where we going? What you doing? Where you going? Come on, get wide, get wide. Oh, he intercepted it. I mean, I'll take going to overtime because the momentum do be a changing. Oh, that's in. And we have the lead, baby. And that's how you do that. Come back from that. Hey, if I beat the boss on this, I'm gonna be like, yeah. Just a thing of beauty. Off, I don't know why we keep doing this off the face-off, but woo, I'll take that. Please tell me that this is, wait, 3 periods. Ah, shit, it is 3 periods, isn't it? Okay, so we gotta hope they don't fuck us again. I thought it was period 3, but okay. Hey, we still have the fucking lead. I'll take it. What the hell? Why is the game still... I was like, why the game still going? Why was the game going in the background? Did anybody catch that on clip? Because, the devs might want to know about that one. I don't know. What the fuck was that? That's why I button mashed it, didn't say my usual intermission report thing. What the fuck was that? No, that was actual time. That was actual goddamn time that went off. So instead of it being... Oh, be gone. Hat trick for Cam Amber. All the ball people in the stands say, hey, give me your hats. Ain't no taking back that one. It's 6-4. Cruising down the street. It is 6-4. Oh, you left him open. It's 7-4. Cam Ambers, fourth of the game. My boy, my man, my homie. Go home, referees. See, that's what happens if your ass ain't cheating. Your ass gets beaten. Understand me. Right there. The spot I like the most. In between the two face-off circles. That's just the ooh, baby. You know what I mean? That does not spark joy. It is 5-7. Come on. We need to run out the clock. We are 2 steps from glory. We are 1:23 from glory. Come on now. Don't be like Toronto. Don't choke. Seconds left. Oh, God, they're... No, you don't. Oh, no. Okay. I need my goalie to stop cosplaying as an Anaheim Ducks goalie. Stop that shit. Yo, if you cost us this lead, I will personally come in and whoop your ass. Understand me. You can tell I'm over here just stalling for time. 19 seconds to go, and we'll have the boss beaten. They have the puck. That was too close for comfort. Oh, that's gonna stay wide, and that might actually save our ass. And that is it. I survived with a Ducks goalie. And that be the boss, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, was turning into Swiss cheese and melting all over the place. But we won by one. And this is why the best defense sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, is a good, high-octane, high-powered offense. Understand me. Can I save after this? Cause I mean, if we still going, but I wanna save. We can come back to this. Oh, there's the menu. Save and quit. Hell yeah. We gonna come back to this. Hey, look, are y'all fine, are y'all all right with me pushing Minecraft Legends back just one more week? Because it looks like we got more hockey to be having. Looks like we survived to the second round, the biggest surprise this side of the Florida Panthers, you understand what I'm saying? Florida and Seattle, actually. Let me give Seattle some props there. Beating Colorado the way they did. Either way, I'm happy you guys are here. I appreciate you guys sticking through 2.5 hours of good hockey footage. Those of you that have a playoff team, meaning everybody in this chat that's not named Michael, I hope you guys' team goes well in the Stanley Cup playoffs, unless they play Dallas or New Jersey. I'm sorry, that's just how it goes. But in the meantime, if you want to support the channel in any way you can, we've got merch and we've got tip. We got a tip jar. Subs, bits, donations, all that stuff. And also thank you for the sub. Let me make sure I got the name right. Jaden Drew, thank you for the sub. That was really awesome of you. We will be back tomorrow night with more, you guessed it, Tony Hawk. So see you then. You guys enjoyed it. I'm happy to have provided it. Good night, everybody.